Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Sakura Cubes and this is Sagar. Today I will show you one of the secret gems of Karnataka, a serene island which should be on your travel bucket list, St. Mary's Island. St. Mary's Island is a popular tourist attraction in Udupi. A set of four islands floating in Arabian Sea is nothing less than a hidden gem. It is a perfect place for an offbeat day out from Udupi. Let's get started to explore the St. Mary's Island. You must be wondering where is this island and how to reach. St. Mary's Island is located in the coastal town of Karnataka, Udupi. The only way to reach island is to take a ferry ride or hop onto one of the speed boat which runs from Malpe Beach. The boat service is available from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. As mentioned already, there are two kinds of boat services available to reach St. Mary's Island. The first one is to take ferry ride from Malpe Government Boating Office. The ferry ride would cost around 250 rupees per head. One has to wait till 30 seats are confirmed, then only they will start distributing the tickets. The downside of taking ferry ride is that it takes a lot of time. You have to stand in the queue to get on board, and the ferry cruises dead slow. It takes around 40 minutes to reach St. Mary's Island. If you are tight on time, then I would suggest you to go for the second option, which is a little expensive but saves a lot of time. The speedboats run from Malpe Beach near the Gandhi statue. It would cost around 400 rupees per head. There is no waiting time either. It will take around 15 minutes to reach St. Mary's Island if you hop onto one of these speedboats. Whether you are taking a ferry ride or a speedboat, it is important to keep your tickets safe because it will be needed to hop onto the boat when you are coming back to the Malpe Beach. The boat service would drop you at St. Mary's Island and instruct you to be back within 1 hour. As soon as we landed on the island, we started walking towards the entrance to St. Mary's Island. The island has several coconut trees adding scenic beauty to the place. Hence, the island is also called as Coconut Island. As we went further, we saw the entire island is surrounded by giant rock structures due to which island still exists. Historically, the island got its name from Vasco da Gama, who stopped by this island during his journey that discovered India. Geologically, the island is one of the 26 geological monuments of India declared by Geological Survey of India. As soon as you step on the St. Mary's Island, you will observe crystal clear water. If the sky is clear, you will also see the blue ocean as you might have seen in foreign beaches. The beach is very well maintained. You will find very less trash around thanks to the ban of plastic in this place. There is no food available here, so it is recommended to carry your own food if required. However, you will get tender coconut water here at slightly higher price than the usual. Take time to explore the island. You can climb on those beautiful hexagonal rocks to reach the other end of the island. The entire place is so photogenic that you will never get tired of clicking pictures even if you are not a photo freak. The black rocks and the blue sea creates one of the most amazing scenery you don't want to miss. Getting into the water is not recommended here as the island doesn't have a shore. The beach is steep, which could be very dangerous to play in the water. As you stroll around the beach, you can collect beautiful shells which are abundant here. Once you are done exploring the island, you can come back to the boat pickup point. There are a lot of water sports activities available here like banana ride, jet ski and parasailing. If you are interested to do water sports activities here, then I would recommend you to explore the island first and then go for the water sports activities. As the time is limited, you don't want to miss seeing this beautiful island than doing the water sports activities. The water sports activities can also be done from Malpe Beach. People are not allowed to stay back in the island. There would be a security guard who will clear the public from island in the evening. If you are taking ride back in the evening, then you can watch mesmerizing sunset on your way back to Malpe Beach. The best time to visit St. Mary's Island is from October to February. During monsoon, the island will be closed. You can call the number given in the description box below to check if the St. Mary's Island is open for the day of your visit. That's it for this video, guys. I'll be making follow-up video of other places to explore in Udupi like Udan Bridge, the Hanging Bridge and Kode Bengre. Do subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Please hit on that like button if this video was useful for you. See you in the next one, guys. Till then, bye-bye.